Hello, dear student. Good morning to all of you and all the interested scientific community in the field of cancer biology. Today, I'm going to discuss an important question or research question connected to the tumor hallmarks. And one of the very important tumor hallmarks, that is lipid reprogramming. So today, question is focused on the lipid reprogramming. How cancer cells are manipulating the tissue microenvironment so that these cancer cells are utilizing selected nature of lipids obtained from the dietary sources, and these lipid content are utilized by the cancer cell for their growth and proliferation and various other needs of cancer cell that allow these cancer cell to be to achieve various other pro-tumor power like metastasis and various other highly ferocious in nature. These cancer cell, what they reflect within a particular cancer patient, and that leads to the death of individual. In this direction, please let me to share a slide. As we discussed today, our question is focused on the lipid reprogramming, and in our lab, in our scientific attempt, we are addressing the question whether the nail of breast cancer patients reflect the different lipid profile. And that lipid profile is connected with the pro-tumor lipid reprogramming within the tumor microenvironment. And in that direction, the obvious question is that, is there any method, is there any approach that can resolve or that can facilitate the profiling of nil metabolites? And that is why it is very important to introduce, or in brief, to summarize the method and approach that can resolve this particular question, whether nail of breast cancer patient has distinct lipid profile over the healthy individual. That may support the already existing views in cancer field that the tumor has distinct lipid reprogramming, where they utilize a distinct type of lipid component, including choline, phosphocholine, or lysophosphatidylcholine, and various other lipid components. Even in previous and some published literature, we have described this method that we claim it as vertical tube gel electrophoresis method. And this method facilitates the extraction and purification of metabolites from nail and other biological fluid system, including urine, saliva, serum, etc. And this particular system, already we have described in previous video and also the other scientific literature, that this is very easy and convenient to work, and that facilitate the purification of metabolites that can be in the nature of lipids, amino acids, carbohydrates, and specifically those are less than 1 kilodalton in molecular weight. Definitely this method is under consideration for patent grant, and also this method is being utilized in our lab to address certain questions on tumor hallmarks, including of lipid reprogramming. So this particular research question, what we started in the beginning, that whether lipid reprogramming by cancer cells within the tumor tissue microenvironment is reflected in the nails of cancer patient, and specifically we are considering today for this cancer patient. So I am going to describe or discuss two model or illustration, one for cancer cell, another for healthy cell. So by making comparison between the cancer cell and the healthy cells, I will try to convince whether the lipid reprogramming by the cancer cell for their own growth and proliferation can also be detected and reflected in the nails of breast cancer patient. So first illustration or the hypothetical model, definitely as we know, we are talking about the, let me to annotate, reprogramming. We are very well aware that lipid reprogramming is one of the feature within the metabolic reprogramming. So in a very short, metabolic reprogramming is one of the highly appreciated tumor hallmarks that is very well known. And within the metabolic reprogramming, the lipid reprogramming is one of the components that allow the cancer cell to go for survival, proliferation, invasiveness, and also the migration to the different body parts. That is the metastasis. So I will try to discuss this hypothetical model that will link the NIL, lipid profile, and the lipid reprogramming by the cancer cell. If you look at this model is of this cancer cell, and that can be also extended to the other type of the cancer cell types. This is the membrane, and this is the intracellular compartment of the cancer cell, and this is the extracellular fluid, that is the ECF or the matrix, you can say. We know that any normal cell or the cancer cell, they have the very well established uptake method of different type of the lipid components, and including if you look at the dietary component, that is the choline as a lipid, they are highly utilized by the cancer cell. If you look at the arrow here, these high uptake of choline inside the cancer cell, these cholines are metabolized by the cancer cell by their own unique lipid lipid reprogramming pathways or lipid metabolic pathways. And these choline are actually converted into the phosphorylcholine by the cancer cells. And these phosphorylcholine are utilized by the cancer cell for very specific purpose to support their pro-tumor lipid metabolism, and that leads to the survival, proliferation, and various other features of cancer cells. In other way, you can say once the choline are high uptake by the cancer cell and the high production of phosphorylcholine and their consumption inside the cell itself, then availability, if you look at here, the secretion of these choline or the choline metabolized products to the outside, that is to the ECF, is highly reduced in case of tumor tissue microenvironment, if you look at it. Not only phosphorylcholine, also the other lipid type like lyso-PC. Lyso-PC is also called as lysophosphatidylcholine. It is also related to the choline metabolism. It is also evident that lyso-PC, a form of lipid, is also going to be less available outside the cell, that is in the ECM. And these lyso-PC formation, or you can say the reduction in the formation of lyso-PC, is one of the hallmark of cancers. That is the fact. But the relevance of these lipid reprogramming in terms of reduction of the availability of this choline or phosphorylcholine or lyso-PC in the ECF is rarely detected in the form of metabolic biomarkers in case of nail of cancer patients. By the use of our own novel VTG system, we are able to show the proof of concept and also the hypothetical figure that possibly the nails of breast cancer patients, they are able to show the reduction in the level of these lipid content, specifically choline and their choline-related lipid metabolized product like lyso-PC and phosphorylcholine. In short, this particular hypothetical model, it connects the existing views on the power of cancer cell to modulate their lipid metabolic pathways intracellularly, outside, inside the cell, and also outside the cell. And due to their distinct power of lipid reprogramming, these lipid contents, choline or lyso-PC or phosphorylcholine, can be seen as a potential biomarker in future based on the reliable clinical samples and also the validation by the various suitable methods. Now I would like to show you what the distinctiveness in case of healthy cell compared to the cancer cell. And if you look at the healthy cell here, healthy cell also are a cell that needs the normal tissue homeostasis, normal growth and proliferation. And in that case, the dietary or normal uptake of dietary choline is possible. And if you look at the cursor here, these are going to be uptake by the normal cell, that is sure. And these choline are going to be converted into the phosphorylcholine at an optimal level. But if you look at in case of cancer cell, these cholines are high uptake and the high abundance of phosphorylcholine inside the cell, intracellular we are talking about. But here in case of normal cell, the normal uptake of choline, then normal and optimal level of phosphorylcholine, and that support the required normal growth and proliferation of the healthy cell. In that way, what is happening, in case of normal tissue microenvironment, the level of these choline and the lyso-PC and the phosphorylcholine in the ECF is at the optimal level. And that is why these lipid content are going to be secreted either through the urine or the excretory system, or it is also deposited into the nails of healthy individual. So in other way, the nails of healthy individual will have optimal level of these lipid content like choline or phosphorylcholine or lyso-PC. That makes a distinctiveness of healthy individual nail sample over the breast cancer nail sample. And this observation is novel in the sense that we have connected the dots. What is happening inside the cancer cell? What is happening inside the healthy cell to the outside? And that is ECF. And then ECF component is going to be deposited into the nails of either healthy or this cancer patient. That makes proof of concept and also the promising platform to look into the possibilities of and also the validation of these lipid content inside the nail, in the nail of breast cancer patient as a part of biomarker. We are not claiming right now this explanation or the observation as a biomarker for clinical purpose, but yes, it gives a platform and proof of concept and the basic idea to validate in future, and we can propose the use of the profiling these choline and choline related lipid content in the nail of healthy versus the cancer patient as a part of biomarker. It is very important to acknowledge the DPU Pune for the state of the art support and infrastructure, all the management authority, our director Professor J.P. Pal sir, all the scientific collaborators for their input and advice, and most importantly all the undergraduate, postgraduate and PhD students for their contribution and their hard work. I'm thankful to all of you. I hope that this video will be helpful to all the interested students and researchers in the field of lipid reprogramming and biomarkers.